हेलो एवरीवन, सो माई सेल्फ सुरेश, लेक्चरर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट पॉलिटेक्निक चेगुंटा। आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद द सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड एडवांस्ड वर्कशॉप टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर डिप्लोमा सेकेंड सेमिस्टर फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट्स। एंड टुडेज माई मेजर टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स। सो द सब टॉपिक इज द टाइप्स ऑफ कोल्ड वर्किंग प्रोसेसेस। So these are the topics so far we have covered in the previous classes, that is cold work, cold drawing, tube drawing and their effects. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the cold working process, such as cold form, roll forming and angle bending. Okay, so first of all we can see the cold bending. So actually we can see the So in previous class we have seen some of the cold working processes. So among them is this is the one of the type of cold working process, that is cold bending. So bending is a non-cutting operation performed on a press. Okay, so performed on a press. So this bending process is nothing but the non-cutting operation. Okay, we are not removing any material from the workpiece, or we are not making them into two pieces of a single piece. So just we are performing a bending, that is pressing. Just we have to apply the force on the workpiece so that the metal workpiece can be bent. So it is a process of transforming a straight length into a curved length. So what we are performing here, so we are transferring the straight length of work metal into the curved shape or a circle shape. Okay, so it is one of the most widely used for forming process. So the cold bending is one of the most widely used process which for forming the different shapes of metals. Okay, next, so plates or sheets can be changed into drums, curves, channels. Okay, so what we can use here, so mainly we are using the sheets or plates. Okay, so sheets or plates can be changed into the drums, curved channels, etc. Okay, next, bars, rods, wires, tubes, structural shapes, sheets are bent to the mini shapes in cold condition through dies. Okay, so what we can do here, so bars, rods, wires, tubes, structural shapes, sheets, are make them into a bent shape. Okay, into different shapes in cold conditions through dies. Okay, next, so we can see here. So during cold bending, the metal is stretched beyond the elastic limit. So what is happening here in bending process? The metal is stretching. Okay, the metal is stretched beyond the elastic limit. Okay, that is stretching of the material. Okay, so beyond the elastic limit, the metal is subjected to tension on the outside layer and the compression on the inside layer of the bending. What is happening here while bending operation? For the work material, so when we are applying some force on on the work material or work piece, so just if we want to make them into a curved shape, the outer surface of the work metal is subjected to a tension, and the inner surface or inner layer of the work metal is into a compression. Okay, next we can see the types of cold bending operations. So these are the different types of cold bending operations. First one is roll forming, angle bending. Okay, so next, cold spinning. Okay, so among them, the first one will be roll forming. We can see here, So actually, what is a roll forming? So it is the process of bending a metal strip by feeding it through a series of matched rolls. Okay. So actually, what is happening here in this process? Okay, the metal strip is fed through it. That is between the series of rollers. Okay, so that we can make a forming here. Okay, that is the cold roll forming. So next we can see. So a strip is a narrow plate or a sheet of carbon steel, stainless steel, or alloy steels. So what type of strips we are using here? So a narrow plate or a sheet, so which is made up of either carbon steel, stainless steel, or alloy steels. Okay, next, a steel is approximately of 0.4 mm to 5 mm thick. So this will be the thickness of the strip, steel strip. Okay, a steel is approximately approximately of 0.4 millimeters to 5 millimeters thick. Okay, next we can see the rolling. So what is a rolling here? We can see. So this is a diagram of a rolling. So we can see the between the two rollers, a metal strip of worked metal will passes through the rollers. Okay, so by the application of pressure from the by the rollers, the worked metal may get stretched. Okay, that is decreasing the thickness of the workpiece and increasing its length. Okay, we can see. Right, next we can see the series of rolls. So this is a diagram of a series of rollers. Okay, here we have a seven set of rollers here. Okay, so between these rollers, okay, so we can pass the what work material. Okay, next, angle bending. Next one is angle bending. We can see. Okay, so it is a process of bending a sheet metal into a desired angle by using a punch and die. Okay, by using punch and die, okay, the metal sheet is may get into a desired angle. Okay, next, the punch and die are designed by the considering the effect of spring back also. Okay, so the punch and die are designed by considering the effect of spring back. Okay, next, a press is used for pressing this operation. Okay, when the metal is bent, the outer surface is stretched and the inner surface is compressed. Okay, next, so bending of press tool. So bending of a press tool, we can see the diagram here. Okay, so bending press tool. Okay, we can see the different parts of press tool. Bending press tool. Right, we can see the parts here. So shank, from the top you can see shank, top set, punch plate, okay, and a punch. Next, from the bottom, so work pad, bottom set, die, and locating blocks. So these are the different parts of press tool. So bending of press tool. Okay, now we can see the bending operation. Okay, this is a di these are the diagrams of a bending operation here. So we can see in these diagrams. So here we are producing a bent at the edges of the sheet, but here in this diagram, so we are make them into a V-shaped sheet. Okay. Right. So what is a purpose? We can see. So employed on components like trays, boxes. Okay. And to remove sharp edges. To remove sharp edges. So strengthen the edges of sheet metal. Just to increase the sail appeal. Okay, that is for purpose of the bending. Next, cold spinning. You can see. So in this process, okay, the pressure forming thin metal by pressing it against a form which is in rotation, cold spinning is exactly similar to hot spinning. Okay, so it is a pressure forming of metal process. Okay, so this is cold spinning is exactly similar to the hot spinning. Okay, right. So metal is formed on a rotating chuck. Okay, so former or die. Okay, so it produces hollow shapes by the application of lateral pressure to a rapid revolving blank. Okay, so it produces hollow shapes by the application of lateral pressure. Okay, so to a rapidly revolving blank. Okay, revolving blank. So there will be a blank here. That blank will revolves rapidly. So for the rapidly revolving blank, so we want to produce a hollow shapes. So by the application of lateral pressure only, we can produce the hollow shapes on the rapidly revolving blank. Next, we can see the principle of cold spinning. A disc made of wood or metal. A disc which is made of either wood or metal. So which rotates by means of a motor. Okay, by means of a motor, it will rotates. Okay, next we can see. The given sheet is stretched. So what is happening here? The given sheet is stretched around former by the application, that is by applying localized pressure to the outside of the disc. Okay, next. The sheet is guided by a simple round ended wood, okay, or a metal forming tool. So what is happening here? The sheet is guided by the simple rounded end wood or by metal forming tool, either by metal forming tool or by a simple round ended wood, the sheet will be guided. Okay, we can see the diagram here. This is a diagram of a cold spinning. Okay, cold spinning diagram you can see here. Okay, next. So we can see the various stages of the cold spinning principle. Okay, so former it looks like a D shape and a hollow block. Okay, between the hollow block and the former, then we are placing a sheet. Okay, that is a flange left unworked. Okay, you are make them into some bend or spin. Next, the disc takes the shape of the male former. So whatever the shape of the male former, so the shape of the male former will the disc will takes the same shape. So this causes a metal disc to form into a desired shape. So this causes a metal disc is converted into a desired shape. Okay. Next, this process is applied only to a relatively thin materials. Okay. So for which type of materials we are applying this process? So this process is applied only to relatively thin materials. Okay. So this way, seamless hollow circular or cylindrical shapes are obtained or produced. Okay. So in this process, or by this way, we can produce a seamless tubes or pipes, hollow circulars or cylindrical shapes are obtained. Next, we can see the applications. All metals available in sheet form can be spin. Okay. So what are the type, based on the irrespective of type of metals. So, okay. So which is available in the form of a sheet, so that can be spin. Okay. Next, to manufacture small number of components. Okay. Next, so complex articles of reentrant shape can be produced. Okay. Next, conical shapes are very easy to produce. Okay, if you want to produce a conical shapes, so by using this process, we can easily produce the conical shapes of the product. Next, ornaments like ornaments in copper, brass, musical instruments, cooking utensils, stainless steels, dairy utensils are produced. So these are okay. Next one is cold extrusion. So next one is cold extrusion. Okay, this is the one of the type of cold working processes, that is cold extrusion. Okay, now we can see. So cold extrusion is also known as a cold forming or impact extrusion. Okay, so this cold form, the cold extrusion is also known as a cold forming or an impact extrusion. Next, so cold extrusion process extrudes metal, okay, so without the application of heat, okay, without applying any heat, okay, so we are extruding the metals. Okay, next, so it is a process of mostly producing a finished parts. So in this process we can produce a finished parts only. Okay, mostly we can produce finished parts. You can see the principle of cold extrusion. A piece of metal known as a slug is cut from the bar stock. From the bar stock, a small piece of metal will be cut. That piece is called a slug. Okay. So using punch and die sets. Okay, by using punch and die sets, so form is created. Next, the material displays or upsets. Okay. Either the material displays or upsets above the elastic limit. So this process involves squeezing or following of metal into the die cavity. Okay, what is happening here? This process involves squeezing or following of metal into the die cavity. Okay, so there is no wastage of metal in this process. Okay, so in cold extrusion process there is no wastage of material. Okay, next we can see the types. So impact extrusion and Hooker process extrusion. Okay, this we can see the impact extrusion here. An unwanted metal blank. Okay, an unwanted metal blank is placed in the die cavity, is acted upon by rapidly decreasing punch. So that transmits very high pressure to the metal blank. Okay. Once again, I will repeat here. An unwanted metal blank is placed. So what is placed in here? An unwanted metal blank is placed in the die cavity. Okay. So it acted up to the rapidly decreasing punch. So that transmits very high pressure to the metal blank, which immediately fill the cavity. Okay. Next. So some metal cannot accommodate in the die cavity. So this metal travels along the sides of punch. So some of the metal cannot be accommodated within the die cavity. So where it will passes, where it will travels. So this metal travels along the sides of the punch of forming a tube shaped components. Okay, next. So we can see the diagrams here. Okay, second one indicates, so impact extrusion process. Okay, so this is before applying the pressure with the punch. This is after the or in process. Okay, so the some part of the blank metal blank will travels with the punch, sides of the punch. We can see here blackish color, this one. Okay, so this will be the metal blank. Okay, next. So Hooker's process of extrusion, an unwanted cupped blank of metal is placed in the die cavity. Okay, next. Punch is decreased to force down the metal, so between the punch and the die. Okay, so thereby what is happening here, producing a tubular shaped components. Okay, next. You can see the diagram here. So first figure is the before going to punch. Okay, punch up cup cupped blank. Okay, so middle one will be the in process, work in progress. Okay, next one will be the finished one, that is the extruded shell. Okay, next. So advantages of cold extrusion, you can see here advantages of cold extrusion: very little scrap during the process. Okay, so during the process very little scrap will be wasted. Okay, next. Tools can be changed rapidly. So in this process, so we can change the tools very fast. Next, complex parts can be produced quickly. Okay, so by using this process, so we can change we can quickly produce the complex parts, that is difficulty components can be produced very quickly. Next, so mechanical properties. Okay, next. So low carbon steel, alloy steels, stainless steels, lead, tin, zinc, alloy, so aluminium, copper can be cold extruded. Okay, so these type of alloys and metals can be extruded in this process. Okay, so gear blanks, bearing races, housings or caps, cartridge cases, radiator tubes can be produced by cold extrusion. Okay, so next one will be a cold working processes. So cold working of metal is carried out below its recrystallization temperature. So this process disturbs grain structure. Okay, this cold process distorts grain structure. Okay, so this, it is adapted to produce a particular shape or form that is not readily available. So in this process you can produce a particular shape or form that is not readily available. Okay, next. So widely applied as a forming process. Okay, so this cold working process is widely applied as a forming process for finished metal products. Okay, next. To obtain thinner material, next, to obtain better surface finish of the metal component, to obtain greater dimensional accuracy. Okay, next. So commonly employed cold working processes are rolling, bending, spinning, extrusion, squeezing. Okay, so now we can see the cold squeezing here. So it is a quick and widely used way of forming ductile metals. Okay, what type of metals we can use here? Ductile metals. So it is a quick and widely used, okay, way of forming ductile metals. So punch and die are used to form the metals. Okay, so here we are using the punch and the die are used to produce or to form the metals. Okay, so the metal is made to flow into the die cavity. So by applying the punch or pressure on the metal, so what is happening here? The metal is made to flow into the die cavity. So this is known as a cold forging process. Okay, next we can see. So the squeezing operation involves severe cold deformation. So requires high amount of pressure to obtain a desired shape and size. Okay, next, for accurate shapes, so punch and die is required. So to get the accurate shapes of the metal workpiece, so definitely here we required a punch and a die. Okay, next, generally performed in a hydraulic presses. Okay, next, you can see the types of squeezing operations: cold rolling, cold heading, cold drilling, cold swaging, short peening, okay, stamping or coining, hobbing. Okay, so first, so we can discuss about the squeeze rolling. Okay, wait for a while. Right, we can see here in cold rolling, the metal is passed through a pair of rollers for thickness reduction. Okay, so in rolling, the metal is deformed into long lengths, okay, between the heavy rollers. So cold rolling is generally performed at room temperature in order to increase its hardness and strength. Okay, so it is also used to improve surface quality, strength and dimensional accuracy of cold rolled products. Okay, so generally squeezing is done at a finishing as a finishing operation, so which improves the surface finish, dimensional tolerance or dimensional accuracy, and increasing its strength and hardness. Okay, so next one is cold heading. Okay, so next one is cold heading. We can see here, so basically, so it is a cold forging process. Okay, so this can be done to prepare a head for components like bottles, screws and rivets. So cold heading is basically a cold forging process for manufacturing of a headed components like, okay, so bolts, screws, rivets and similar items from the ductile materials. Next, advantage is that no metal is wasted during cold heading operation. Okay, there is no wastage of metal in the cold heading. Okay, next, so cold heading parts possesses high strength. Okay, so cold heading process high strength. So bar stock is held in a pair of jaws as shown in figure, such that the position of the length to be headed is projected out of the pair of jaws. You can see in this diagram here. Okay, so bar stock, this will be the bar stock. Okay, so this will be the bar stock. Bar stock is held in a pair of jaws. These are the jaws. Okay, such that the position of length to be headed is projected. So out of the pairs, pair of jaws. Okay. Then the projected portion is subjected to repeated blows, okay, by punch until a rough head shape is obtained. So for this extended projection bar stock, just you have to apply the pressure or make punches on the extended bar so that it can be shaped into a head shape. Okay, a rough head shape is obtained. Then for better size, shape and accuracy, then headed part is repositioned into another die. Okay, so what is happening here? For to increase the accuracy, shape and size, the headed part is repositioned into the another die, okay, as shown in this figure, okay, in the second figure, okay, here we can see, okay, so that we can get a exactly head. Next, after heading, threading is done by rolling methods. Okay, so after preparing a head on the bar stock, so what you have to do? You have to prepare a threading, okay, by rolling method to prepare a complete bolt. Okay, to prepare a complete bolt. So what is happening here? So we are preparing a threading by the rolling method. Okay, by rolling to produce a complete bolt. Okay, so thread rolling uses two flat hardened steel dies. Okay, so what we are using here? We are using the two flat hardened steel dies, okay, to prepare threads on the bolt. Okay, bolt is placed on one die. Okay, another flat die kept on blank is reciprocated. So what is happening here? The bolt is placed on the one die, so another flat die kept on a blank, okay, that is bolt and reciprocated. The bolt is rolled between the two dies and threads are formed. What is happening here? So by moving the flat die, okay, on the top of the bolt may get deformed, or it can form threads on its circumference. Next, threads formed by rolling are stronger but not suitable for making internal threads. Okay, so by using this thread forming, okay, or rolling method, so we can produce only the external threads, but we are not producing any internal threads. This is not suitable for producing internal threads. Okay, here we can see a diagram here. Stationary die plate and reciprocating die plate. Between the stationary and reciprocating die plates, so part to be threaded. Okay, here is simply example bolt. Next. So cold reeling. Next one is cold reeling. So the process is similar to that of hot reeling, except that the metal is deformed at cold stage. Okay, so this process so this cold reel this process is usually applied for smoothing and finishing the tubes. Okay, this process is applied for smoothing and finishing the tubes by using mandrel. Okay, you can see in this diagram. Okay, next one is cold swaging or rotary swaging. Cold swaging or rotary swaging. Okay, so it is a process of reducing the diameter or tapering the surface of tubes. Okay, so in this process, what we can do, what we are doing here? Here we are reducing the diameters. Okay, reducing the diameters or tapering the surface of the ट्यूब्स, बार्स, वायर्स एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व द फिगर हियर. यू कैन हियर वी हैव स्पिंडल एंड ब्लैक ब्लैंक हाउसिंग डाई क्लोजिंग पोर्शन डाई ओपनिंग पोर्शन एंड रोलर्स एट रोलर्स. ओके राइट, सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिड्यूसिंग डायमीटर्स ऑफ रॉड्स ट्यूब्स एंड बार्स रोटेटिंग द डाइस सो विच ओपन एंड क्लोज्ड रैपिडली. ओके, द ऑपरेशन इज परफॉर्म्ड इन ए स्वेजिंग मशीन. ओके, वेयर वी आर परफॉर्मिंग दिस ऑपरेशन, सो वी आर परफॉर्मिंग दिस ऑपरेशन इन ए स्वेजिंग मशीन विच कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ ए हॉलो स्पिंडल कैरिंग डाई आई शोन इन फिगर. ओके, आई शोन इन फिगर. नेक्स्ट, द बार हूज डायमीटर इज टू बी रिड्यूस्ड इज केप्ट इन between dies. So between the dies, whatever the bar we are going to be reduced, that bar is going placed between the two dies or two or more dies, so we can reduce the diameter of the bars. Okay, the die sets will rotate. Okay, so when the die set touches the rollers, the die will closed. Okay, during which dies will hit the stock to reduce the diameter partially. Okay, so once dies crosses the roller, the dies are opened. Okay, once dies crosses the roller, the dies are opened. The process is repeated until required diameter is achieved. Okay, next, short peening. So it is the process of indenting large quantities of steel shards into the surface of metal. Okay, into surface of the metal. Okay, so this is done by air blast or some mechanical means. Okay, so this is done by hurling or throwing small shards, that is metal balls. Okay, at high velocity onto the work surface. So as shown below in the figure. Okay, so as a result of indentation, favorable compressive stresses are developed at outer layer. Okay, so this increases the fatigue strength. So this increases the fatigue strength of metal. At the same time, its surface is slightly hardened and strengthened. Okay, next, stamping or coining. Okay, right, so it is a process of indenting letters and figures or patterns on one side of the workpiece to a depth of 0.5 mm to the 1 mm. Okay, so with the help of a punch and the die. Okay, next, so you can see here examples, coins, medals, etc. Okay, this is the procedure. Okay, so next one is hobbing. Okay, so it is a process of producing cavities of a desired form on a blank of soft metal. Okay, so these cavities may be used as molds for molding and die casting. Okay, the process consists of forcing hardened steel form hub into the soft metal. Okay, so during the process, the blank is restrained into a retainer ring to prevent lateral flow of metal. Okay, next one is cold working. In cold working of metal, the metals are worked below the crystallization temperature. Okay, so high pressure are required to plastic deformation of metals. Okay, so deformation of metals is brought by slip plants. Okay, next we can see the effects of cold working. So grain structure is distorted. Okay, next, lattice distortion takes place on the metals. So resistance to working increases. Okay, so residual stresses are built up inside the metals. Okay, next, so heat treatment processes need to be conducted, okay, to remove the residual stresses developed inside the metal. Okay, to reduce the to remove the residual stresses. So what is happening here for the metals? So we are make them into a, we are going to heat treat process. Okay, next, so strength and hardness increases. Okay, so we can increase the strength and hardness of the metals. The ductility decreases simultaneously. The ductility of the metal will decreases. Okay, next, surface finish of the product will be improved. Okay, so what is happening here? The surface of the product will increases or improved. So next, close dimensional tolerance can be obtained. Okay, so dimensional accuracy can be obtained closely. Next, so recrystallization temperature for steel is raised. Okay, for the steels, the temperature, that is recrystallization temperature, will raise. The more ductile a metal, the more it can be cold work. Okay, next, dimensional properties can be improved. Okay, so what we can increased here? So we can improve the directional properties can be imparted. Next, imparted directional properties may be determined. So excessive cold working leads to crack deformation. Okay, so excessive, that is more cold working, leads to the cracking formation of the metal, on the metal. Okay, next, resistance to corrosion will, okay, resistance to corrosion decreases. Okay, next, so spring back is and lever present phenomenon. Okay, spring back is and lever present phenomenon. Okay, impact, then impact strength decreases. Okay, next we can see the advantages of cold working. So accurate dimensional controls can be obtained. Okay, so accurate dimensional controls can be obtained. No surface oxidation results. Okay, there is no oxidation takes place in this process. Okay, so smooth surface is obtained. Okay, next, cold working is useful to increase hardness in metals. Okay, so which do not respond for heat treatment. So this is employed chiefly as a finishing operation or process. Okay, next we'll see the limitations of cold working. So higher pressure and heavier equipments are needed. Only small sized components can be easily worked. Okay, next, sections of more than 25 mm diameters are rarely cold worked. Okay, so sections of more than 25 mm diameter are rarely cold worked. Next, as shaping process, it is limited. So only to ductile materials, only for ductile materials, the shaping process will be limited. Okay, next. So grain structure is not effect refined. Next, residual stresses may cause harmful effect. Cold worked components often needs to be performed heat treatment operations. Okay, next, I will stop here.